Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to become a web developer from scratch and find a job. If there's one job that's easy to pick up with no prior experience or education at all, it's web development. You can get started right now. In a few weeks or months of study and practice, you'll have a working understanding of how to develop a website. If you're looking for resources or want to know more about the job you're getting into, we've collected the best learning platforms, tools for web development, and all the other info you'll need to get started right here. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, let's get started. Web development may not be for everyone, but it has a shallow barrier to entry and it's one of the most accessible jobs you can pick up. Despite this, it pays reasonably well and web developers are always in demand. That's not to say that the work isn't often challenging, but the fundamentals are very quickly self-taught. Breaking into the ever-growing tech industry is always a good choice long-term. If you're willing and able to pursue popular coding languages, and in web development, there's always a hot new language employers are scrambling to hire for, you're almost guaranteed a steady job. Finally, web development is a flexible job. Your career may be spent doing freelance work or at a company with a salary. The tasks you do and the skills or languages you focus on are up to you. If you're considering becoming a web developer, it's good to know what sort of salary you can expect and how easy it will be to get a job. The consensus is that the average developer makes between $60,000 to $75,000 a year or more. Of course, the pay will depend on your experience level, the languages and technologies you pursue, and whether you freelance or work a steady job. But it's a reasonable estimate to start out with. As for demand, the U.S. Bureau of Labor predicts that demand for web designers and developers will grow 8% from 2019 to 2029. For reference, that's double what most occupations on average are projected to grow. Web development is one of the most straightforward jobs to get into if you can figure out programming. Mastering web development will take ongoing work and dedication, and it's a job that offers a challenge and requires problem-solving skills. The exact requirements depend on where you're specializing. For instance, a back-end developer should generally create and edit a database, but you can't expect the same from a front-end developer. Regardless of specialization, here are some skills and knowledge you'll need. Proficiency in at least one web language. Depending on your position, you'll likely need to learn more. Knowledge in other related skills like web frameworks, libraries, and Git. Problem-solving skills are required to work with and debug code. Attention to details to stop bugs from happening in the first place. Communication and team skills are essential to work with other developers, clients, designers, and testers. A degree of independence in being able to problem-solve on your own. Self-motivated learning is another necessary skill for success. And familiarity with popular web development tools is valuable. You don't strictly need a college degree to get a job. Experience and a complete portfolio are often far more valuable. More and more job listings are skipping out on requiring a degree and opting to ask for proof of experience. As this is a highly technical field with plenty of room for self-teaching, it's more important that you know how to do the job than that you're certified to do it. That said, a degree will make it simpler from the start. Web development is a highly specialized career. You'll rarely find a person who describes himself simply as a web developer. Depending on what you do, which part of the website you focus on, and what technologies you work with, you can choose from a wide array of job titles. Front-end developer. A widespread choice as the skills are easy to pick up. Front-end client-side developers work on the front-facing website. Languages of choice are HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Bootstrap and jQuery are also popular technologies. The back-end developer. These developers work with technologies like the server and database. No back-end developer is the same as there are dozens of back-end programming languages. Common choices are Java, Ruby, PHP, Python, and MySQL. A full-stack developer. A combination of front-end and back-end developers. They know enough languages to get by on the server and client sides. These are the main three, but you can specialize further by becoming a web engineer, security expert, WordPress developer, mobile web developer, web application developer, and more. First, you need to choose how you'll learn development. Will you be going to college? What sort of degree are you pursuing? An associate's or bachelor's degree related in some way to computer science is best. If you're not going to college, will you try to get certified? Certification or not, will you take a paid or free online course? Or are you going all in to teach yourself using only online resources? After you've decided that, you'll need to pick a specialization. You can put this off as you experiment with different aspects of web development, but you need to choose before pursuing a narrowed study. Next is, what programming languages and technologies do you want to learn? All this may come in a different order. You may choose to specialize or go in already knowing what languages you want to learn and then select a course accordingly. After you've picked up some web development skills, get some hands-on experience by setting up your own server and building out your own website. Once you do these things, you'll be ready for your first job. Are you interested in learning WordPress development? Get Dev Kinsta. It's a free development suite that makes starting up a local WordPress server painless. Use it for testing and development and push the final result right to a Kinsta server. Are you ready to try web development yourself? We've collected some great resources to get you started. If you're choosing to teach yourself or learn online, this is the place to start. And for those going to college, they're great supplements to your courses. The first rule of being a developer is to use Stack Overflow. Every developer knows that this is the place to turn to when you're stuck on a project. Your question has likely been asked and answered. If not, the community of experienced professionals is eager to help. While this isn't strictly a beginner's learning resource, it will be there for you every step along the way. W3 Schools is an excellent beginner's resource that will walk you through the fundamentals of various web languages and standards. It's super easy to understand, even if you're not used to coding. If you need a beginner-friendly course that offers over a dozen languages and technologies, Code Academy is the place to turn. Better yet, the bulk of the content is free. While there are premium features, the courses themselves are fully available at no cost. Need some more advanced courses or ones and more specific skills? Udemy might be the right site for you. There are thousands of courses made by professional instructors, and some even allow you to become accredited. Git can be very difficult to understand if you have no prior technical skills. It's easy once you get the hang of it, though, but crossing that first hurdle can be tricky. GitHub Learning Lab walks you through it with a simple, fun, and interactive tutorial. Do you want to learn code and get certified while doing it? Unlike Code Academy, Free Code Camp is 100% free due to it being a nonprofit. Each certification path is estimated to take around 300 hours, and you can choose from a variety of different skills to learn. Any developer knows that finding documentation for dozens of different tools can be annoying. DevDocs is a free and open source tool that combines all of this documentation into a single, easy to navigate app. Treehouse is a helpful beginner's resource that aims to teach you web development and other fundamentals from scratch. The video-based learning platform also includes interactive challenges. Though it's a premium service, it's also an excellent starting point for developers. Coursera has one unique advantage unlike the other learning platforms. You can use it to earn both certification and full college degrees from technical universities. It could be cheaper than enrolling in college, and you'll learn nearly the same content and work with the same professors as university students. As Coursera offers accredited and non-accredited courses, make sure you know what you're getting into if you're aiming for a legitimate college degree. Egghead contains helpful bite-sized lessons on a variety of development subjects. There are several dozen topics to choose from, each with even more articles covering every development aspect you can imagine. You can also find courses offered by professional instructors. There are coding boot camps for beginners that will teach you the ropes, as well as programs for professionals that will keep you on your toes. While colleges or other classes often offer them, you can also do online boot camps. Some of them are paid courses and some are free. It all depends on which one you choose. There are plenty of coding boot camps online, but you can start by looking into Hack Reactor, Full Stack Academy, and Codesmith. If you've chosen to work for a company in a salaried position, the next step is simple. Start applying. You can find job listings through online sites like Google Careers and Indeed. But what if you've chosen to do freelance? Your first step should be to build a website that will serve as your online portfolio. But the clients won't come to you, you'll need to reach out. Networking is the best way to land clients. Get involved in open source projects that may introduce you to people who can help you get a paid job. Advertise your business wherever you can, and whether you'll be freelancing or looking for a traditional job, you can also check out web development job boards. And don't forget, at Kinsta, we're always looking for talented developers, so you might want to bookmark and check out our careers page, and who knows, maybe apply in the near future? We would love that. Got any other tips for becoming a web developer? Please share them with us in the comments section below. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.